Priya Maheshwari, and today I will explain you the series combination and the parallel combination. So firstly, I will tell you what is the series combination and what is parallel combination. If all the resistors in the circuit are combined and are arranged in a series, then it is said to be in series combination. And if all the resistors in the circuit are joined in the parallel, then it is called as parallel combination. So today I will show you how to calculate the equivalent resistance among series combination and parallel combination. So firstly, we will take series combination. So we can understand it by the given example. Here I have taken a circuit. The three resistance are there in the circuit. This is the resistance first, this is the second, and this is the third resistance. The potential difference across the resistance first is V1, potential difference across resistance second is V2, and as the same V3. The total potential difference of the battery we can take is as V. This is the ammeter. Now from Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to IR. As the given circuit is in the series combination, therefore the current flow, that is I1, I2 and I3, will be the same because the given resistors are in the series. So I can say that I is equal to I1, that is equals to I2, and that is also equals to I3. Here, this is that I will talk about the overall voltage or potential difference of the circuit. Let's talk about individually potential difference and resistance and current of the circuit. Here, now I am going to add all this. As we know, the sum of all voltage will be equal to the total voltage of this battery. So V1 plus V2 plus V3 is equal to the total potential difference of the given current. So here I can write it as V, that is equal to I R1 plus I R2 plus I R3. From here we can write V as IR. So I will write IR, that is equal to I R1 plus I R2 plus I R3. As the I is the magnitude of I is equal in each resistor, so I will take it as common. Also, I is in both sides, so we can clarify it and write it as R equivalent, that is equal to From this, we can state that the equivalent resistance in a series combination is equal to the sum of individual resistance among all the three combinations or all the three resistance across these three potential differences. So, I have showed you how to calculate the equivalent resistance in the series combination. Now, we will see how to calculate the equivalent resistance in a parallel combination. Here also, I have taken an example of a circuit. We have to calculate the equivalent resistance between the point A and B. Here are three resistors between A to B. These are first, second and third. Also, the current flowing among this is I1, which is across resistors first, I2, which is across resistance second, and I3, which is across resistance third. As the initial and final point of the all the three wires are same, that's why the potential difference among this will be the same. Now, again from Ohm's law, we know that current is equal to voltage upon resistance. So This is the formula for the overall current, overall voltage and overall resistance of this circuit. Now we will take it as individually. I1 is equal to V upon R1. I2 is equal to V upon R2. And I3 is equal to V upon R3. Again, we will combine all these and we will write it as now, as the voltage among all these are equal, so we will take it as common. As the sum of all the currents is equal to the total current flowing from this, so we can take it as I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to the total current flowing from this. So we can write it as I. From here, we will replace the value of I and write it as V upon R is equal to V 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. As the value of V is common both sides, we will cut it out and we will find 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. From this, we have found that the reciprocal of the equivalent resistance of the given figure is the sum of reciprocals of the resistance first, resistance second and resistance third.